with my Google account, and we'll meet at the other side of the platform and we'll start and see what we can do. Okay, so as you logged in, you will be welcome with this Biteable dashboard, and to your left over here you can have some tutorial on how to make your first video. You can invite a team member using these two videos. So you can search for templates, there are a bunch of them. You can check, you can see many templates. You can just you can move over here and you can see a bunch of templates that you can always use. Try it to see. These templates are actually editable. You can edit the content and make them your own, and as you hover over them you can see a preview of what it looks like and what you should expect. Recently added templates are also down here, and you can see ads also over here that you can use to kind of make them your own and make them available for your company depending on what kind of text you have. So let's try to edit this and let's see what we can do with this. So right now we'll be welcome with this video. I think you don't need it, so we can just close it down. And you can see this is the Canva, okay, where we can have a preview of our video, and we can always have check out the timeline over here where we have the different components or the different slides, if you call it, if you may call it slides. You have the bunch of slides over here, and you have the option to start, or you have the option to choose a soundtrack. You can add a soundtrack over here. So, and over here you can have the different kind of, you can click to add different kind of animations or different kind of media. You can have from animations, you can bring in check out videos and images, okay, that are pre-existing that you can easily use for your videos. And you can have favorites, you can search and mark as favorite, and you can see you can even upload from your content from your document, okay. Drag your video or image files here to upload, or select a file from the desktop, or you can upload directly from here, or you can just click on this and you can upload a given file or a given image or a video directly from your desktop. You can also drag and drop alternatively, right? So let's say we are taking on this and we are taking it, and we can upload it easily, right? So you can see it as part of our upload. You see your scene has been uploaded. So you can see the different kind of things. You can add media from here directly, so you can see it has just added it to our timeline, okay. Down here you can check out the different styles that you can bring in, okay. So these are 14 slides all together, and you have this as the third slide. You can click here to edit. So for example, when we double click, yeah, you have them slide 1 to 14, okay. So you can change the coloration over here. You can click and change the color over here. You can click and change the ribbon. You can select any ribbon color, and you can see it has changed it completely to red, okay. So you can make it the previous one, maybe you can make it black. And I think red kind of looks cool. Oh, let's go with this color. No, I think dark red maybe can look cool. Yeah, I think this kind of looks okay. But then you can change the background also if you want. You can change the background color. Right now it's set to white. You can change it to any color of your choice. So let's try this. So let's say we are done with this. You can reset all scenes also if you want. You can reset. So right now we have reset it, and we can come back to edit. And you can continue with the editing of your video. So down here we can see my picture, but then you can click on this arrow on any slide to see it. You can add caption, you can add logo, you can duplicate caption, you can delete a caption if you want. And by selecting this particular slide, you can check from the right hand side, you can see the replace background. You can replace this background, and you can increase or decrease the placement. For example, we can decrease, you can zoom out so that you can cover the whole picture. Okay, so you can see it clearly. So let's make it 30%, so you can see. And alternatively you can click on your own to use the adjust it on your own using the manual method, okay, to adjust until you get it correctly. And you can write something from here. So let's say for example you can double click to write, and you can change the position also. You can move it down or sideways accordingly. And you're free to check the coloration. This is the text feature. This is the different free to change the coloration. Let's say we have this, and we just bring it down here a little bit, and you can play around with it. Text animation, elegant rise. You can put in different animations accordingly, or slide with reveal. You can adjust this. and make it quite small and then move it to the side. Down here you can play to have a preview of how the whole thing is going to look like. So just play and see. And you can see the navigation from one stage to another. Alright, and you're free to replace each and every one of them accordingly, depending on your kind of message. You can stop if you want, and you can start from the first one. Let's say this is, you can replace this. You can easily replace the background. So you can click on replace and you can choose anything according to your message. So let's say we choose this one. We check the different kind of folders. So let's say we go with profession and we choose anyone depending on the kind of message you want to send. So let's say we go with this and it's loading it. Okay, so it has loaded and you just have a preview of it at the beginning. You can see. So you can start your video or your audio together so they can play together. So let's say we can want to add an audio track. You can click to navigate and add an audio track from anywhere. So choose an audio track. So you can see a bunch of them. Right now it's set to no track. You can check the tracks accordingly. You can select a track. I think this kind of looks cool, but you can select this one also and try. You can select anyone also. Chill lyrical roots. Right. I think the first one kind of looks cool, so we can just go with it and save it. Okay, it has just added it, so we can play the preview also to hear about it. So this is just a bit, this is just the preview. You can replace the track also if you want. You can delete it. You can change or increase or decrease the sound volume from here for your outlet. You can enable fade in and fade out if you want, so that you can have a professional finishing on your sound. Okay, so this is how to bring in. You can come all the way to the end. If you don't want a particular slide, you can select it and you can come to this arrow and you can delete the scene directly. Okay, if you want to add a scene, you can always come over here. You can close this. You can always come over here to add a scene and you click to add a particular scene from the bunch of scenes that we have. So you can check either from animations or from a video clip or from a favorite or from a new upload, just like we have explained. So let's say we can add from intros and outros. So let's say we want to add an outro from here. Let's say we are going with this. So we'll just select it and it will load it over here. So you can see it directly over here. You can edit the video if you want. So you can just click. Once you click on it, it's going to bring in the dialogue. So you're free to edit it. All right. So you can just put in. And you have the text features over here. You are free to play around with them. For example, the ribbon color, you can change it to red if you like. You can change it to this color. I think red kind of looks cool. And you can change the font style, okay, the font weight and the sizes all from here. And you have the other features also. You can change the write up. Thank you. And once you're done, you can change these ones also. Maybe you put in your credentials down here and you're free to delete or you add another feature from this. Okay, on anyone, you're free to add something like that. You can add a layer or you can delete it easily. All right, so once you're done, you can have a preview of it. You can play the current scene from this very small playhead. You just click to see the current scene, how it's going to look. Okay, so this is the last scene, which is an outro. So you're free to bring in an intro or many more. So you're free to edit these clips accordingly until you're done. So once you're done, the next thing you can do is you can come over here to export. You can click on export to export it. Okay, so you can see your video. You can build a video over here. It's free. It's watermarked. You can see the watermark. So you say build the video. And you can always restart the build from here if you want. If you are not certain or you want to stop the video and make some more editing, you can always stop the rebuilding and restart again and check out and edit your content and then rebuild back again. Your download is ready. The video is finished, the rendering. Okay, so you can always You can close this and you can try to play it to have a preview of it. You can play it to just have a preview. You can see how clear and interesting it's looking. So down here you can download this video to your desktop and you can add some call to actions if you want. Okay, and you can copy the link and share it with other people. This is enabled. You can share directly or you can preview the page that you can share this on. So there are a bunch of features, there are a bunch of ways in which you can share your videos with people, and you can always share it on. You can get an embedded code and so you can put it on your website or on your blog. You can also get an embedded code for, you can paste it, you can share it on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, and even LinkedIn directly without you downloading the video. You can share it directly from here. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, this is just a bit on how to use Biteable for your video making and editing. Feel free to share it, to try it with and experience it. If you enjoyed this video, please remember to give it a thumbs up and don't forget to hit the subscribe and notification buttons to stay connected to this channel for more of our very, very useful videos. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.